Ladies, gentlemen, and those of non-binary gender, welcome to another episode of Bull Plays. As always, this episode is made possible by the amazing support of my Patreon backers. In particular, this week, I'd like to thank the Arcology Podcast for their longtime support. If you're a fan of Shadowrun, actual plays, or just fun podcasts in general, check out the Arcology Podcast at arcologypodcast.com. I'll put the link in the description down below this video as well. So this week, I'm going to fire up one of my favorite game franchise series, Tropico, and play through the fifth installment in the series, released in 2014. For those not familiar with it, it's a sim management and building game where you're the ruler of a small tropical island and you need to deal with the changing political landscape of the world around you. Keep your people happy, and in the campaign games, you have to deal with various obstacles that will crop up to cause you problems. How you rule is up to you. You can be a kind, caring president, doing his best to nurture his people, or you can be a cruel and ruthless dictator, crushing dissenters under your heel. It's a lot of fun, and it's one of my favorite sim-type games, and I've enjoyed the entire series, but Tropico 5 is probably the best entry into the game so far. I generally play the game as a good president, trying to do my best to keep the people happy and safe. So for this game, I'm going to mix it up. I'm going to try and play as a ruthless and domineering as possible, and see where that takes me. So let's go ahead, and we're going to start a brand new game. We've got Changing the World is the base game. We've got Lord of the Pearl, which is the Waterborne campaign. Let's go ahead and do Changing the World. And there you go. All right.
You know those people who establish dynasties so powerful that their names echo through the centuries? I'm one of them. New world, new opportunities, no limits. This island of mine could become anything. It could be a farmer's heaven, the fields reaching the horizon, and the markets full of people. Or it could be a production powerhouse with chimneys reaching the sky and docks busy with all sorts of exotic goods. Or it could be the paradise on Earth, a magnet for travelers from all over the world, a place for fiesta and fun.
Sir, we're docking the ship, sir.
For now, it's just a dirt poor piece of land in the middle of the ocean. Let's make it shine.
Okay, so we've got our first mission, A New Dawn, Win Your Independence. Alright, the economic and political difficulties, just how difficult things are for the game. I'm going to keep those on low because I don't want a really hard game. Disasters suck. Typhoons, volcanoes, tornadoes, volcanoes, what did I say? Just all kinds of crap that can just really wreck your day, destroy a whole bunch of people, kill a bunch of your citizens, and are just a really big pain in the ass to recover from. So I'm going to leave that on rare. And then you've got your choice of two different islands. Now the way this is going to work is you'll choose one island to start on, and then as the game goes through, you'll basically skip back and forth between the two islands, building them up from game to game, which is kind of cool. So we will start on this one.
Ah, the Caribbean, a lush and untamed land, my new home, beautiful and full of promise.
A new beginning, far from the politics of the old world. A chance to start fresh and do things my way. I'm tired of the musty weather and rigid thinking back home. I need a change. I was appointed governor of this island. Not that anyone else wanted the job anyway. My unique approach to government will make this colony the most prosperous in the Caribbean. Huh, how hard can it be? You just need some planks, a few nails, and a trusty advisor to shout at.
Welcome to the Caribbean, Governor. Allow me to introduce myself, Lord Oakesworth, His Majesty's emissary to the region.
Alright, you'll occasionally get these guys that'll pop up that will give you missions. Besides them, there's also Penultimo. You'll meet him in a minute. And I can't remember her name, the one radio announcer girl. So anyways, we are starting off the very beginning of the game. We're in the colonial era. So we are a subject of the crown of England. And we have a colony that we are ruling in his name. We have a certain number, basically we have a mandate, which is a number of years we have until we lose the game. We can complete tasks sent by His Majesty, and we get extensions to your term as governor. And what we're trying to do is win our independence, either by raising enough of a military force that we can declare our independence and fight off the crown, or make enough money that we can just buy our way out. Of course, we also have to make sure our people, which if you look here, the little thumbs up, it says 26%. We need at least a 51% approval rating, I believe, to win our independence. This shows our starting money, and we have 70 citizens on our island right now. So first things first, I'm going to go ahead and hit pause. I'm going to spin the camera around, and we're going to zoom out just a little bit. All right, so right now in the older eras here, we have what there's this fog of war, or whatever they call it. Basically, it's unexplored area, so I don't know what's over there, and I can't build into that area yet. So I only have this little area to build in. I can select soldiers to go out and explore. It costs money to do that. They will go out and explore a little area and come back, and they reveal some stuff. And then real quick, my starting buildings. I have a dock. Ships come in and out from here, bringing more settlers and exporting out anything that I produce to sell. This is how I make money, is through my docks. I have Teamsters. Teamsters will ship goods back and forth to the dock. The more Teamsters I have, and the better they're, the happier they are, the quicker that will happen. And the Teamsters are a vital part of this game because they're how things get from place to place. You have a construction office. We'll send out people to build stuff when you need to build new stuff. Houses for your settlers. And I start with a plantation, which is growing corn, which my people will eat, and I can also sell. And then you also have your palace. The palace has a squadron of guards, and if the palace is ever taken over by invading forces or rebels, you automatically lose the game. And then I have a quest. All right, let's go ahead and...
Greetings, old chap. Have I got a deal for you today? As crown representative, I can offer you your very own trading license.
All right. Now, one of the other things you can do is you can set up trade routes. You get one trade route per dock, and then later on there's a building you can open up that will give you an extra ship per dock, a trading ship. And these trading ships will let you sell some of the products that you make for a higher value. They will also let you buy stuff that you're not making for yourself. So if I need more food for my people, I can set up a trade route to import food. Or if I wanted to produce, like, say, jewelry, but I don't have any gold mines, I could import gold to make jewelry out of. So I'm spending a little extra because it'll cost more to import that stuff than I would make selling it. But if I'm processing it into another material, I can do that. Also, it's possible to get trade routes. You can get a good deal on a trade route coming in and find a trade route that sells it for even more going out. So in theory, it's possible to make a little bit of money by being a middleman, but that's kind of not really a good... I don't really find that to be all that useful. I'm going to go ahead and I don't want to drop my crown relations too much. So I will buy a silver package. Unfortunately, I got to buy some money, but it cost me a little bit of cash. But we'll go ahead and pause and we will check out my trade routes. So you got trade routes for various different things you can make: agriculture, food, agriculture other, which is cotton, pearls, various other things you can make, mining and logging, industry goods, and luxury goods. So I can export bananas, and you can see here I could get 1,000 for them, and the default price is 800. So I'd make 200 extra per unit of, or per 1,000 units of bananas that I shipped. Or I could import corn. And again, you can see it's 480, but the default price is 400. Right now, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up some cotton fields. And I'll start, I'll start exporting cotton. I like that. So we're going to go ahead and set that ship up, and despite the fact that I don't have... one of the other things is the higher the budget on the dock, the faster your trade routes, ships will come in. So that's really handy. A bunch of other stuff to go on. Got to give a quick overview of some of the basics of the game, I suppose. So the Almanac. This tells you all kinds of different statistics about the game. The important one here is usually the happiness, because this tells you a couple important pieces of information. One, how many homeless you have. Housing is always a major issue with this game. Right now, you can see I've got a handful of houses here, but I also have these shacks. Because the houses they're only set up to house four families. And each family is up to two people. So each house can only hold eight. I have four houses, so that's 32. But I have 70 people, which means I've got a lot of people who currently don't really have any housing. And as you can see here, I have 31 homeless. I also have 14 unemployed. That shows you how many people I can put into my workforce. You want to be careful not to overbuild buildings. Build too many buildings that you don't have enough people to work them. Because that ends up just... your buildings end up kind of stagnant, or they're producing very, very slowly. So it's kind of a waste, because you're still have to pay upkeep and wages and stuff, and if it's not producing enough, you're not really making any money. At this stage in the game, it won't be quite as important, but eventually I'll have to deal with healthcare. So I have to set up clinics and eventually hospitals. Religion, you need like churches and such. Liberty, which is how happy the people are. There's various edicts you can issue that will help the liberty. And media buildings, newspapers, and then later on TV. Food, the more food variety and the more food is available, the happier the food happiness will be. Entertainment, you can set up things at places for people to go to get entertained. And crime safety, which will be things like police stations and other stuff. And then the other thing to keep an eye on is... your relations. You want your, you've got your various factions on the island. So you got royalists and revolutionaries. And right now I've got a lot of royalists, and they don't like me. And I don't have many revolutionaries, but they do like me. And eventually I need to get a lot more revolutionaries if I want to become independent. And then right now the only faction I have to worry about pissing off too bad is the Crown. If they're rating, which could go from 100 to 0. If the rating drops too low, they will actually... I'm not sure if the Crown will actually invade or if I'll just lose the game. But I know later on, some of the superpowers that you'll be dealing with can actually invade you. They'll send ships and they'll send in troops. And you have to defend yourself against them. So, alright. So let's get a couple of things done here before I get too into this. One, I'm going to go ahead and get some roads placed. I like my settlement to have some sort of, you know, to make sense. So I tend to build in squares so I can fill those in with buildings and stuff. And the other thing I need to do is then go into plantations. And I said I wanted to build cotton. Alright, you can see some of this is showing like green, and then you've got the grid that shows kind of an orange, yellow. The areas that are green are really good areas to grow these crops. Areas that are orange or red are really bad areas to grow. And then yellow is kind of in the middle. So we were going to throw a couple of these down. Not the best place to build, but we will go ahead and do one there. We're going to do one here. Extend this road out just a little further. Because you need to make sure that that road there is connected, so that way you have a connection for the Teamsters and whatever to come and pick stuff up at. And I'm going to set up a Teamsters office here. Right there. Okay.
His Majesty needs money to build a new underwater palace. He wants you to begin growing money. I mean, one of those crops that make heaps of cash.
Ah, he wants sugar. I should have built some sugar. See, and that's one reason you should probably check those before you start building things. So right now, I'm mostly broke. Because I spent more money than I should have there right out of the gate. So the only thing I can do is hold out. Hope somebody sends me some money. The Crown will send me cash occasionally. I will get these things that will give me cash. And as soon as my stuff is built, I'm going to get, I'll be able to start getting some money from them. I'm going to go ahead and bump the construction priority up to high. That'll help target your, there you go, that'll target your construction workers, telling them that this is the building that you need to do more than the other.
Technological progress is the path to autonomy, Governor. We need more scientists to think important thoughts and discover new stuff.
All right, this is another big important part of the game is research. You have to build a... There's libraries, and then eventually there's other buildings that will produce research points. The research points will let you research a bunch of different things. So, right now I can't build a mine until I research the shovel. The farms and ranches both have upgrades that will make them better, but I can't do those upgrades until I research these. Then later on, I can get lumber mill, productivity skills from the foreman, military fort, newspaper, etc., etc. So that's how it is, you know, it's your standard research and development tree for these type of sim games. So. Alright, we got a little bit of money coming in now. Not a ton. Not great, but we'll see what happens. I desperately need some more houses. You can come down here. You can zoom in pretty far. You can see all the people going about their day. Yep, and see, there's the trade ship taking the cotton. And then this one's taking my corn out. Actually, I'm going to go ahead. It's going to put me into debt a little bit, but we're going to go ahead and do the sugar plantation. Not the best location, but it's not terrible. So we'll do that. Now you can
we
see
are the shadows that move the world. We rule in secret. We are the salvation of mankind. We are the order, and you will be one of us.
All right, so now I need to declare independence to win the mission. And as I said earlier, I have to have popular support above 50%, etc., etc. Right now, my popularity is 8. A big part of that has to do with the housing and such. It's up to 10. You'll note there I have 67 people now instead of the 70 I started with, and that's because some of them have died. They will die of old age, and they will die of illness. So I need to get more stuff built. But of course I need more money for that. So we will wait and see what happens. There we go. Crown sent me some money, and I got a ship that came in to export some corn.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
All right, so I completed. I got the sugar plantations, and I can get a 12-month extension. I can get 10 citizens. I can get $5,000 to my Swiss bank account. The Swiss bank account is used to upgrade your dynasty members. I'm not going to worry about Swiss bank quite so much right now. I can deal with that later. Right now, I'm going to take the treasure subsidy because I need cash. I need citizens too, but I've gotten some of them.
Being able to stand on your own is a virtue I personally cherish. Self-sufficiency should be every country's goal.
Alright. Well, I need 15 grand, but I'm going to have to spend some money because I need to make my guys a little bit happier. So we are going to go ahead and drop a few houses. One of the nice things about these country houses is while they're kind of crappy house quality, people don't like them that much, they do basically have their own gardens. So the people grow their own food that are living in them. So that's kind of nice. There we go. Yeah, see, I can't do the clinic. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to get a clinic until the World War era. So, as I said, we're in the colonial times, and as the game progresses, we'll go to World Wars, then Cold War, and then eventually Modern Era.
The burden of ruling
Oh, now he gives me the build new country houses. Alright, well, like I said, right now all I can really do is wait and get some money.
I say, being a crown colony is a kind of competition. One you are losing, old chap. The colonies of Puerto Coco and Isla Rojo are beating you badly.
Crap. Well, pay the money. I need to start getting some extensions, because I'm going to start running out of time here if I don't do better.
His Majesty has commissioned the finest...
Alright, well that will help. Homeless, unemployed. I don't have any unemployed, so I need more people, really, before I can do much. But, not much I can do about that.
Being able to stand on your own, the burden of...
Money is always a problem. And yeah, I dove in just a little too fast. I really shouldn't have built those cotton plantations out of the gate. I should have waited, then I could have built the corn. Or the sugar. But it's been a while since I played the base game, so I didn't remember what the missions did. Well, that one's on me. So we'll just kind of chill and see if I can get some money here quickly. I can go into debt a little bit. So... you know, as needed. Yeah, let's do... Yeah. Oh, hey, there we go. I got some... Crown sent me 6,300. Alright, so let's get some houses going. There we go, 5 houses. That will complete that. My sugar's going nicely because I am at least producing some decent amount of sugar. And I need a new library, but that's not going to happen anytime right away.
I see the houses are ready. Unfortunately, the islands of Puerto Coco and Isla Rojo have kidnapped the managers intended for you.
They offered large mansions to get the managers from under your nose. Don't worry too much about it. You'll be able to get them back at some point. In the meantime, I use the orders connection to get an extension to your mandate. Alright, excellent. So, I got an extra year. That will help. I still need more people, but... there we go. And now the people that were in these shacks are moving in, because these shacks are terrible. Nobody likes them. They drive down the property values, make the area ugly.
Your family's rather... rollicking love life has led to an unexpected pregnancy.
Alright. As any other important birth, the event will grab the attention of people far and wide, may even cause some controversy. Alright, this is where I get my first extra dynasty member. I could build a new Catholic mission in 9 months. You know what? Let's go ahead and do that because I need a mission anyways for religion purposes. So, that's going to put me a little bit into debt, but that is okay. Got some trade goods. Almost done. Hurry up.
As the heir was born, all animals became quiet. A light shone through the skies, and La Chupacabra herself went to the crib and bowed to the infant. At least, that is what we will write in the history books.
Alright. So I can choose what skill they get, because we're using an ancient ritual involving heavy rum drinking. Residential constructions are 5% cheaper. I like that. They really like this geek costume, don't they? There we go. Yeah, so you can level them up, but it costs Swiss bank money, and I don't have that. So now if something ever happens and my president was killed, I have a backup. You will also get things
His
where you
Royal
can...
Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Alright, as I was saying, you occasionally get missions you can send your dynasty members off on, and they will sometimes give you benefits and whatever. Alright, I get to choose again. I could take money again, and I really could use the money, but... I could use the colonists, and I could use the extension. Let's take the extension. That'll be a little safer. I'll end up needing to do other things later anyway, so... Let's build the library, because I got to get that stuff started. So expensive. I have 6 unemployed and no open jobs. Although the library is going to take care of that a little bit. One of the other things, though, is that you'll notice that some of the jobs say education illiterate. Some of the jobs say education high school. And once this one gets built, it'll say education college. I can eventually build high schools and colleges to educate my citizens. But for the time being, I just sort of have to hope that the citizens coming in are actually educated. I can also, like, pay a crapload of money to hire, like, college-educated citizens, but it kind of sucks. Yeah. Alright, I need something else. Well, let's just wait and see. Oh, actually, I should build a tavern and get some... Get some entertainment going.
While His Majesty finds your island's back...
There we go. Yeah, see, it'll take 7 months right now because... Well, I've only got 2, so I'm ranking 33. If I get a third one, it'll make more. Actually, bump that up. Higher budget basically means that they're getting paid more, which means it's more likely to attract people to come work there. For the moment, we will just kind of chill, and hopefully we're making more money than we're spending, than we're... Yeah, we're kind of making more money than we're expending every month. So that's a plus. few things I'd like to build, but for the moment, I want to wait and see what quests we have come in, and I want to get this money. I want to get that up.
Governor, I have made contact with a certain group of not-so-reputable sailors who would gladly pay extra thanks to your efforts. The revolutionary movement is growing stronger.
Alright, so every now and then you'll get a quest, sometimes that you'll automatically complete, because in this case, I had to have a trade route going. I did. Fortunately, I can get, and one of the nice things is I can get revolutionaries, which are something I need to up my percentage for declaring my independence, and B, they're educated. So, that is a plus. Educated citizens are always a good
thing. His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the Empire.
Alright, this time I'm going to take the treasure subsidy.
Great news! While searching through the crates of colony supplies, we found a sickle! Now we have something that goes perfectly with our hammers. This will boost production sky high. I can almost see the glorious future.
Plantation upgrades unlocked. Alright, Penultimo is your main advisor. And he's basically a complete ass-kisser and kind of a dumbass. He's pretty funny, though. Alright, let's get the shovel going. I'm almost there. Next ship, so one more month and I should get the...
I am afraid that your colony is still doing rather poorly compared to your neighbors, Puerto Coco and Isla Rojo. His Majesty is not pleased.
I'm not going to pay that tax, so we're just going to give him the finger. What does that put my relation at? Now, the downside to the crown relations being lower is that I will get less money at the end of each year, which kind of sucks. I got that come in, but it didn't quite push me over. So I'm going to have to wait till the cotton ship gets here. And I need to start building some defensive buildings. So one of the things I can build at the moment is guard tower, and then eventually get the military fort. I gotta get a couple forts in place. So, let's see what we can do here.
Our research team, that is to say me, discovered the shuttle.
There we go. That ought to make enough money. There we go.
A troublesome band of corsairs has come to steal your treasures.
Crap. Alright, fortunately it's only one. So I've got one unit of troops. They've got one.
Hey! War is hell.
But...
His Majesty personally inspected several reports from your...
Okay, so... I need to do a couple of things here. One, we are going to get a couple of these in place.
Many people are ready to give their life for their ideals. You must be ready to take lives for yours.
This guy's creepy as fuck, I tell you that.
Governor, my special friend.
Okay. So, I need to upgrade a couple plantations. So, let's... do that.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this...
And I will take the subsidy. Hopefully you guys
are doing well. Your right to rule has expired.
Women love men in uniform.
There we go. We beat them back, thankfully. All right, let's get... I need some more... right, since I wanted another dock, we will build one.
Great news! We found that.
Alright.
Construction of His Majesty's underwater palace has begun. The crown requires a great many tons of your crops to help pay for this massive project.
I can send half, I can send original, or I can send double. Does get me the mandate increases. This gives me the revolutionary support. Send half. We're trying to play kind of a bastard guy, so we're going to basically give the crown a finger and see how fast we can get our independence. How are we doing? Homeless, unemployed. Alright, so I can set up another plantation going. Get a little bit faster on the I'm getting that set back up.
We just discovered the number of times you need to get hit by a plank to actually discover something. It is around 7, depending on the plank in question. We call this the plank constant. I am sure it will become very important one day.
Yeah, these research things are all an awful lot of terrible puns, by the way. All right.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary...
My good fellow, I have it from a very reliable source.
All right. So, they want me to explore and find a gold mine. Well, I've got 3 mines over here, 4 mines, 5 mines. I've got a couple of mines over there. And there's a string of mines over here as well. So the question is where is the gold mine at? Well, let's come over here this way first. Is there one? Yeah. Let's come to here first. Let's see what happens. I also would really like to get a military fort up and running. So I'm going to have to get some stuff going. Do this. Oh, I also have another trade route now, so let's see. We don't have anything out. Got cotton, coffee, cocoa, logs, iron. Alright, so we won't set up the other trade route yet. So I don't have anything that I'm producing currently.
The sea is too crowded. It is full of lost cities, rich American industrialists, and sleeping alien gods. His Majesty has no desire to mingle with such things.
Construction on the underwater palace has been stopped. From now on, you will receive fewer, if any, options to extend your mandate. Oh, okay. So let's take the extension. Since apparently we may not get more.
Someone stole my manuscript and published it under a pseudonym. It was an autobiographical story about 2 men on a mountain who want to form deep male bonds. They even stole the surrealistic chapter where fairies prance under a rainbow. The circumstances behind the theft are very queer.
That's awful. Alright, I can get the need constitution. the trade offer has been expired. So I'm no longer getting the cotton trade. So I will need to set something else up here as soon as I have the money. A little bit there, bunch there. Alright, what did we find over here? Nothing there. Alright. I will have to go looking for others. Because I do not remember where it is off the top of my head. There we go. Explore. These change pretty quickly, so it's not a bad idea to keep an eye. Alright. That's a pretty good one. It's the smuggler, so I'm going to lose standing with the crown, but screw the crown, we don't like them anyways.
My black market contacts say that they have it.
Alright. Is expensive.
I understand that you have a lighthouse, old chum. His Majesty wants you to appoint a royalist as the new keeper of the lighthouse. It is of the utmost importance.
Being a keeper of a lighthouse is a very responsible job that brings both status and wealth. Don't ask me why, it just does. Well, I can get a 6-month extension, or I can hire a revolutionary. I could use the revolutionary support, but I'm down to 3 years. That makes me nervous, because I don't have tons of time, and it goes fast. Let's take a chance. Hire a revolutionary. Because I can still get some if I get this gold deposit, I believe.
My good fellow, I have it.
Alright, edicts. I've got martial law, military drills, extra rations, no free lunch. No free lunch would be good. Right to arms. Mardi Gras, no right to arms. Martial law. Martial law will be useful later on to stop elections. But for the moment, how are we doing? Homeless 9, unemployed 7. I just don't have... I know one thing I can do. Alright. We've got coal mine. And I'm at 2 years.
My friends, these smugglers inform me.
Four docks? Oh man, there's not even one up there. Alright, let's explore. To think that that's one.
Disaster. The revolutionaries are demanding that you insult the king.
Insult
the best
the
way
king.
To insult the king would be to seduce his queen. That is obvious.
Let's give her a
unfortunately,
gift.
Your gift not make it to the queen. It was lost in the humongous pile of gifts from her other suitors.
I really need to have another another one of these going here. So let's put it there.
Things do not look well for you.
Bah.
So, there was gold in those mountains. Jolly good, old chap. I believe it's only fair that I get a piece of the pie, having supplied the information and all that.
Sure. That gives me a 6-month extension.
Presidente, after suffering...
Pearls. Iron, iron, logs, iron. Gold. Gold would be nice. Gold's far too far away. I can't set something up there.
I sat with 3 other members of the research.
We are the shadows that move the world. We rule...
All right. Well, we're close. Let's see if we can get these docks. There we go.
I understand you are still struggling with trivial things like money.
Yep, we will take the money. Thank you.
Presidente. Ooh, I'm getting ahead of myself. God. Presidente.
Ooh. His Majesty is most amused by...
Well, I've got 3... Well, we'll see what happens. They sent 3 troops. I've got 3 troops. All the ones up there. But I also do have some of these, which will do a little bit of damage. So hopefully that's enough to...
Surrender and live.
Well, they destroyed the one.
Charge! This is gonna hurt you bad.
I need my life.
Charge! This is gonna hurt you bad.
I like the fact that...
We will fight you in the streets and on the beaches.
Alright, well... Hey, we got one. We might actually make it out of this. Huzzah! I have won! I think. Alright, so now I can set up my constitution. We will do that. Let's see. Military. Let's go with conscription for now. Atheist state. And, yeah, only wealthy citizens vote. Because we're assholes. Let's rebuild.
If you think that the communists and the capitalists are a bunch of crazy...
Welcome, brother. Today, you and your family join a select few who have taken upon themselves the burden of governing the world.
Congratulations, you are in. Here's your membership card, your ceremonial dagger, and robes. Membership fees are due the second Monday of each month. Since you are our newest member, I will continue to guide you in your endeavors. I will also remain in your primary contact with the Order. Alright, well, that doesn't sound sinister or anything now, does it? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. I've been Bull. Click like if you like this video. Subscribe to my channel if you're interested. And please check out my Patreon if you're interested in supporting me to help me make these videos. I do role-playing games, I do short stories, do all kinds of different stuff over there. Check it out if you could. Alright. That's it for me for now. Thanks a lot. Catch you next time.